Hello, today we're going to be dissecting a sheep brain. So again, as with all our dissections, it's important to orient yourself. This is the anterior or cranial aspect of the sheep brain. This is the caudal aspect, or what we would call in humans, the posterior aspect. This is the dorsal aspect, and this is the ventral aspect. So if we turn this over, we're going to see structures on the ventral side here. And remember, we have some protective coverings on the brain, which in this hemisection of the brain that we can actually see very well. So remember, we have what we call the meninges, and the meninges, there are three layers. We have the dura mater, we have the arachnoid, which sits below the dura, and then of course we have the pia mater, which is directly overlying. So here you see this glistening aspect here with the vessels kind of in here. That's going to be the pia mater. So it's very tender, very thin, directly overlies my nervous tissue. Here you have an example of the dura mater. So this stuff right here is super, super tough. And usually the dura mater and the arachnoid is kind of fused, and you might actually see fibers that are extending to the pia mater, and that's what we call the subarachnoid space. So I wanted to be able to show you this so you can appreciate the dura and somewhat the arachnoid mater, and then of course the pia mater that is over here. If we turn this brain section and look at the ventral aspect, again, you can see the dura, but most of it has been removed. As you pull this away, if you start to see little fibers tearing, that's gonna be your arachnoid mater. So just appreciate that these are protective coverings for the brain and help reduce friction and trauma to the brain tissue itself. Looking externally, we're gonna focus more on this specimen right here. Again, this upper portion here, this is going to be the cerebrum, and we have some lobes that are very important. We have our frontal lobe here, okay? We have the parietal lobe, which extends over this posterior dorsal aspect, and then we have the occipital lobe, which will be right in here next to the cerebellum, okay? And then, of course, laterally, we have our temporal lobe on either side. There's also a hidden insular lobe, which is deep to this tissue. We're not going to look at that today. From the side view, so we can kind of take a view from the side. We have our temporal lobe, frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe here, and then cerebellum. And extending away from the brain, we have our spinal cord. If I take the brain and turn it about 90 degrees, we can see the underside of the brain. And again, this is anterior, this is posterior or cranial and caudal, if we're talking about a sheep, and we can see the underside here. Again, we can see the temporal lobes to either side here. We have some cranial nerve structures. The actual cranial nerve is what extends into these olfactory bulbs here, but these are what we call the olfactory bulbs, and these are going to be the olfactory tract to the brain for the sense of smell. Additionally, we can see here the optic chiasma, and this is where the optic nerve is coming in. It's been transected here, and some of the fibers will cross and some will stay on the same side, and so we have like a little X here. We're going to remove this tissue in just a minute, but I wanted to orient you. Additionally, you can actually, there's some hard parts here that are actually going to be bone, and then we've got the pituitary that's kind of sitting and dangling from this tissue here. So right above that will be our hypothalamus, and then as we extend caudally, we've got the pons, and then the medulla, and then we've got our spinal cord. So what I'm going to do as we to look at the inside of the brain, we're going to make a sagittal section. So we're going to extend right down the midline, okay, right down our longitudinal fissure, and try to go all the way as evenly as you can, straight through the cerebellum and through the spinal cord. And I might not have it exactly even, okay, but we're going to extend out through here. And so by transecting the brain, we're now going to be able to look at the hemispheres. Again, I've removed the pituitary because it's stuck in this tissue right here. But here we have a lateral section. We can view either one of these. I think we'll go ahead and, let's see, I might actually use this one. This is a hemi section here, and the color's a little bit better, and probably a little more even than my section. So again, if we're orienting ourselves, we have the cerebrum here, okay? And I'll use both of these so we can do that. So we've got the cerebrum up here. We have this band of white matter here. This is called the corpus callosum. Remember, this is going to be connecting our right and left hemispheres. If we look in this tissue beyond this, there's actually going to be a space in here. We have our lateral ventricles, so you can see this better here. And this right here is the corpus callosum. So cerebrum, frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe. This is my corpus callosum. And then we have, of course, the lateral ventricles here. Okay. Additionally, we can orient ourselves. Here's our optic chiasm. So this is the crisscrossing of the optic nerve. Here we have this round structure here. And so our third ventricle is going to be in and around this. This is our thalamus. So you're going to look for this to orient yourself. Just posterior and a little bit superior, we've got the pineal gland, which is sitting up here in this area as well. So right here we have the thalamus. Below that is going to be our hypothalamus. And then below that is going to be the pituitary. So remember, major endocrine structures here, maybe major homeostatic mechanisms. Remember, the thalamus is also going to be our connection up to the cerebral cortex. So very, very important. And then as we move exterior, caudally, we're going to see a couple of things. This area right here is going to be our midbrain right here. So you can kind of see some swellings there. I'll see if we can see it maybe in this one as well. So you start to see this bulge right here. We've got midbrain coming back here. And so again, we've got midbrain here. And as we move further, we've got pons. So pons should be at about the level of the cerebellum, which is this structure here that sits outside of the cerebrum. Remember, the cerebellum is for balance and equilibrium and fine tuning your motor plans here. And you can recognize the cerebellum by this tree-like looking structure. We call this the arbor vitae. And so that the light stuff is the white matter and the outer portion is the gray matter. Just like with the brain, our white matter's internal and gray matter is external. And then just below that, we should have the pons and then medulla and then the spinal cord. When we're talking about the ventricles, remember, these are important structures. So again, we had our lateral ventricle up in here. There's one on each side. We have the third ventricle here, and we'll have the fourth ventricle that's right in this area connected to third. And then this will go out and there'll actually be connections to the subarachnoid space up and around the brain itself. And then of course to the central canal, which goes out and then of course around the spinal cord itself. So this is going to allow for that cerebrospinal fluid to go all in and around our central nervous system structures.